Let's talk money. The Prusa XL with 5 tool heads, $4,100 ready built. The K2 Plus, $1,500 ready built. That's a $2,600 difference. Can the XL actually justify that price tag? The K2 Plus seems like the better deal. It's enclosed by default, comes with active build space heating, air filtration, a camera, and the color filament system, which holds 4 spools and acts as a convenient filament magazine. And the XL? Actually comes with none of that. Though with the XL being a tool changer, that's here where things shift. Every color change on the K2 Plus wastes filament. While the XL is a tool changer, it can eliminate purge waste completely. In addition, the XL segmented heat bed only heats what's needed. Unlike the K2, which always heats the full bed, the K2 Plus is fast. Very fast. But how does that help over the slower XL? Stefan from CNC Kitchen did a very deep dive on tool changing versus multiplexing. A must see if you like to learn more in detail about those differences. In this video, we compare the Prusa XL and the Creality K2 Plus at both print times, energy efficiency, and filament waste, because that's where the cost difference lies over time. How much money can the XL save over the K2 Plus, and for which user might it be the cheaper machine over time? Spoiler, we won't have a definitive answer to that, but there's a lot to find out. So, let's dive in. Thanks to PCBWay for sponsoring today's video. PCBWay offers a wide range of services like CNC machining, sheet metal fabrication, 3D printing, injection molding, and of course PCB production. Getting a quote for your projects is easy. Upload a file of your design, specify the parameters, add additional information, kindly wait for the quick shipping, and you're ready to go. Check out the link below in order to go the PCB way with your project. Measuring power consumption isn't just about costs. I also wanted to see how efficiently each printer transforms electric energy. Using Nuus A1T smart plugs with Tasmota, I logged power draw and energy consumption throughout the printing tests. But before diving into printing, I ran some isolated tests on the key consumers to test my Python script for energy logging and to learn more about the extents of nozzle and bed heating on both machines. First, a quick note on idle power of the two machines. Both printers consume around 20 watts in idle, meaning if you left one of them running 24/7 all year, they'd burn through over 175 kilowatt hours. That's around 50 euros per year in my case here in Germany, and around half of that for an average US citizen in US dollars, without even printing a single part. For all the plots and values on heating nozzle and bed, each printer's idle power is deducted from the measured values. For the hot end, we can see the 100 watt heater of the K2 Plus acting here, while one Prusa XL toolhead uses a 40 watt heater. That's peak power during heat up. Once temperature settles, the power draw drops significantly for holding the set temperature. That holding power draw, in average, is what's interesting in the long run, like at printing. Also apparent, how much faster the K2 Plus heats up the nozzle. For PLA temperature, the K2 Plus is more than double as fast. As you can see, differences between PLA, PETG and ABS holding wattage on the nozzle heater are rather low. Keeping temperature on the nozzle draws not much power in general, though the K2 Plus needs more power to keep the nozzle heated. That's probably due to the longer melt zone on the hot end. Multicolor printing versus single color printing will become interesting on the XL, as it needs to heat and hold temperatures of up to 5 heaters while printing, depending on model and way of painting. On the printbed, the K2 Plus is equipped with an 800 watts AC heater that conventionally heats the entire surface. The Prusa XL in comparison uses 16 individual DC heater tiles, each 90 by 90 millimeters, drawing around 430 watts while heating up the full bed. As you can already realize here, in this case, the XL's average holding power draw is higher than on K2 Plus when temperature settles on the full bed. So the bed of the XL draws a maximum of 27 watts per tile, meaning smaller prints will consume less energy. Though, how well will that work in practice? Here is where it gets really interesting. The XL segmented bed doesn't just heat the active tile, it also warms all surrounding tiles at a lower transition temperature to create a temperature gradient from the active hot one to the cold inactive ones. This means even for prints below 90 by 90, there is always more than one tile powered. So, it's always best to position prints near the corners of the bed. Auto-arranging in Prusa Slicer is mostly aware of that. For the XL, I measured the average power draw for holding temperature for 4 scenarios. 1 tile for prints up to 90 by 90, 4 tiles for prints up to 180 by 180, 3 by 3 tiles and the full bed. You get it. Doing that for each PLA, PETG and ABS temperatures generates a lot of data, so I guide you through step by step. First, let's look at PLA temperature. Obviously, printing small PLA parts on the Prusa XL saves energy. There is still an advantage at using 4 tiles, or prints up to 180 by 180. Though, as soon as a 3x3 pattern for prints up to 270 by 270 is used, the power draw for holding temperature is almost equal to the full 350 by 350 K2 plus bed. Using the full bed on the XL at PLA temperature draws even more in average than the K2 bed. Looking at PETG and ABS temperatures, this effect gets emphasized. The higher the temperature and the more tiles of the segmented bed are in use, the less efficient it becomes. This could be due to power losses in the XL's complex wiring of the tiles, DC power conversion inefficiencies, or due to the segmented concept and the design of the tiles itself. I'm curious, leave a comment if you have ideas on that. Now that we had a dive into power consumption data for nozzle and heatbed, let's see what happens in actual prints. I tested single color and multicolor prints to have a look at waste, print times and energy use. I started with a 4-color 3D Benchy, probably a worst case scenario for a multiplexing printer like the K2 Plus. Small object, fine details, a lot of color changes per layer and therefore plenty of purging and time waste. To minimize filament swaps and print time, I used a 0.25 layer height at speedboat race settings on both. On the XL I used a prime tower and dried the filament beforehand, otherwise those fine details didn't work and stringing took over. As expected, waste and print time were vastly different. The XL finished in around 2 hours, while the K2 Plus took close to 9 hours. Both prints came out at around 11 grams, but waste was another story. 19 grams for the purge tower on the XL versus a massive 190 grams on the K2 Plus. Over 300 color changes took their toll, with each switch requiring purging on the K2 Plus, costing both time and filament. Average power draw was around 127 watts for the XL and around 164 watts for the K2 Plus, making the XL not only way faster all in all, but also a bit more energy efficient for this. Yeah, sure, that's a very specific use case. The estimates for print time were accurate on the K2 Plus. For the XL, Prusa Slicer predictions were off for the print time. But there's a reason for that, which became clear later. For comparison, I also printed a single color 3D Benchy at the printer's 0.2mm default profiles. Here the K2 Plus is noticeably faster, but average power consumption on the XL was again lower, since here's only one single tool head and only one tile of the heatbed active. So, the difference in average power draw for the single color 3D Benchy versus the 4-color 3D Benchy on the XL is 36 watts. That's the cost for this one of keeping multiple toolheads at temperature for the swapping. Considering time and material saved over multiplexer printers, this is very acceptable for PLA printing. We'll check that again on a longer print for that 4-color Deadpool bust, one of those prints I had wanted to do for a very long time, but I couldn't justify the incredible waste on multiplexing printers. All PLA filaments used were dried to go without purge tower on the XL. Zero-waste multicolor printing worked well on the XL per se, but there were other issues. During the tool changes, I observed random delays on all toolheads of up to 15 seconds on all multicolor prints I did so far since the XL arrived here. This adds up at hundreds or thousands of tool changes per print and makes print estimates unreliable for the XL for now. According to Prusa support, this is a firmware bug that will be fixed in future updates. Additionally, I noticed temperature variations on the parked toolheads. Correlation? Question mark. By the way, PID tuning is not meant to be done by the user on the XL. Beyond that, I couldn't finish the print even after 3 attempts due to an extruder not spinning error on toolhead 1. Then on toolhead 2. and finally also in tool head 3. I'm in contact with Prusa support to find solutions for those problems, but for now it didn't make much sense to go on with much more testing on the XL. I still managed to print a single color version of that Deadpool bust though. Estimates for print time and material usage were spot on here without tool changes. The fails of the multicolor version consume an average of 43 watts more than at single color and, according to the slicer estimate, the painted one would require just under 3 additional hours for the filament swapping. With around 1500 tool changes, the extra time for color swaps calculates to 7 seconds on average, which aligns closely with my observations when that delay bug doesn't interfere. So there's still a chance for usable print time estimates in Prusa Slicer. The K2 Plus completed the Deadpool bust successfully and it also looks very good. One problem though was a clock on that perch slide, which was solved by simply removing it. It took almost 2 days to print and wasted 1.3 kilograms of filament. That's an insanely expensive Deadpool bust if you ask me. Even though only 4 tiles of the Prusa XL bed were in use, that advantage in average power draw is still there at multi-tool head printing, but it comes close to the K2 Plus which heats the full bed, but only one tool head. Still, it does that over a way higher amount of time. Creality print estimates are shockingly accurate here. What's clear? The segmented bed of the XL is unlikely to amortize the price difference to the K2 Plus, but if you print a mix of small and large parts, the XL can benefit your wallet, the environment and your conscience. So for me, concepts like this are very welcome in general. On the XL, the power difference between one color and four color printing is somewhere between 30 and 50 watts, which is negligible compared to the massive material and time savings a tool changer offers over multiplexing systems like the K2 Plus. Yes, that four color Benchy may have been a ridiculous test print, but just like the Deadpool bust, it highlights the biggest flaw of multiplexing printers. Let's look at two trending print farm scenarios for multicolor printing production. One favoring high-speed multiplexing, the other favoring tool changing. The first one favors the K2 Plus style of printing. Small, colorful, mass-producible models printed across the entire print bed, like the wiggly toy trend currently booming in print farms. Here, color changes apply across multiple models at once, allowing the K2 Plus to leverage its speed between swaps on huge layers. The material cost per plate is $21 on the K2 and $13 on the XL, but the K2 Plus weighs 390 grams of filament per print cycle due to purging. The XL, despite being slower in printing per layer, avoids waste almost completely and finishes with an overall cost per plate of $15 versus $23. Over a full year of production, at 50% uptime, this sums up to an annual saving of $923 for the XL and 62 kilograms less wasted filament. Now the second scenario favors tool changing. Larger, highly detailed models with frequent color swaps. The printers can fit 6 200mm Deadpool busts per print cycle. An example for a realistic, high-margin multicolor product. Here the K2 Plus suffers heavily from its purge system, wasting those 1.3 kg of filament per cycle. As expected, the XL's advantage grows. Annual savings jump to $1,350. The yearly waste for one K2 Plus climbs to 154 kilograms. Sure, these are extreme business scenarios and most likely not your waste or your cost. But my message here is a different one. Think about the piles of unnecessary plastic waste generated by home users running the incoming wave of cheap multiplexing printers marketed for the fun of colorful figurine prints. This isn't just about cost, it's about efficiency, sustainability and how we should approach multicolor printing in the future. If you like this video, subscribe, ring the bell, give it a like and consider supporting me on Patreon. Servus und goodbye! Shout out to our gold supporters, Gatsby and Chulo.